Good morning. Okay, another overpayment situation. It is possible to get an overpayment as a parent of a child who's getting SSI. Generally, the parent is the representative payee of the child. And for the child to have been getting SSI, the parent's income had to have been low enough that the child was still eligible because, the children, are deemed to have the income of the parents to a certain degree. So once the parents' income hits a certain threshold, that income, that excess income, is going to be deemed to the child, considering the parent spends their income on the children. So, of course, as you know, SSI, any income we get, earned or unearned, will ultimately be counted against SSI and there will be an offset. So, still the Canadian smoke. So if a parent's income is forthrightly noted at the time the SSI award is going down for the child, so he's medically disabled and then they're inquiring about being physically disabled, I mean financially worthy of the SSI disability, meaning under the threshold poor enough, then you know what your income is and you know that your child is still eligible. If your income increases, it's going to affect potentially, particularly if you're now over the threshold, the eligibility of the child or the amount the child should be getting. So once your income hits a certain amount, and you're going to want to know what that amount is, so find that out. And speak to the SSA about what that level is for you under your situation. They usually look at whether you have eligible and ineligible other children and spouse. So it can vary, but I mean, if you have more children, you're obviously going to be expected to have to use some of your money for those, and that therefore wouldn't then necessarily hurt the SSI child's benefit, because that income is not being used by him. So, but again, you can have an overpayment. If you get a raise, take a new job, increase your income, it's going to potentially affect your child's eligibility for whatever amount he's eligible for with SSI. So you have to really stay on top of this. A lot of overpayment situations occur from this. And then you're stuck having to pay it back. Now, if you do have to pay it back, there's a couple options you have. If you don't disagree with the fact, the mathematical fact of the overpayment, and you want to determine that first, you can seek a waiver of the overpayment if it would be a hardship, as defined by the SSA, and that if it's not your fault. Now, if you forget to report that your income went up as the parent who's not disabled, I don't know that that's going to be considered fault in terms of wrongdoing, intent. It's a mistake on your part, but it's not necessarily bad intent. So don't get too worried if you forgot to report, but do it as soon as you realize so that you don't have an overpayment. However, that said, a lot of times people report, and there's still going to be an overpayment because the SSA does not react to a report in real time. So, a month today, where you report that you had more income, is going to be there, the child's already been paid. So it'll have to come out later. And that's how that overpayment kind of develops, even under the best of circumstances. Again, SSI is like a thumb on the pulse of your neck. So, it's a wonderful program and very needed, but sometimes it can be more hassle than it's worth for some people. Asking for the waiver again, not, through no fault of your own, and it's got to be that it's a hardship to pay back. And when they say hardship, they generally don't mean, you racked up a bunch of credit card bills going to Disney World and you got to pay those bills before you pay back the SSA. No, it would be it's supposed to be your basic living needs, not extravagant living needs, your basic survival needs, and what you have after that, you pay the SSA before you pay Visa. That's my understanding. Okay. So if your basic needs are going to be struggling, if you have to pay a little bit back every month, they might feasibly waive the obligation to repay. It's worth asking for if indeed your income is that tight. If your income is not that tight, it's still a big bill. You want to ask probably for a reasonable payment plan. I've seen some report that some offices will say, well, we won't take less than 100. I don't know if that's true. But accordingly, I mean, if you think 25 you can do and it's not going to, you know, affect your family's life in a negative way, 25 is probably doable. If your income is low enough, the SSA may entertain that. So, you know, ask for lower. Don't start out high if that's going to be a struggle. See what you can do in terms of getting something that's not going to cause you too much pain. Okay. That's called a repayment plan. And you can request that. And they'll probably want to see your finances as well for that. So waivers and repayment plans. That's your option if you are not appealing the fact of the overpayment. And remember, everything has deadlines and appeals have very strict deadlines. So you have to read every letter you get, every time you get one from the SSA, line by line, and always look for something that says you have the right to appeal. Because if it does, you got to see if you agree with the facts that they put earlier in the letter, or if there's something you need to appeal. Okay. Anyway, overpayments, everyone's nightmare. Hope yours isn't too big.